I think the typical Christian still thinks of heaven in the same way that Greek philosophers, Plato included, tended to think of heaven. This ethereal place, the disembodied spirit floating around. In other words, very different than what Scripture teaches. Resurrection is the exact opposite of this floaty, ethereal idea. Resurrection means that as Christ rose from the grave in an actual physical body, he ate and drank with his disciples, he talked with them, he walked with them. Likewise, we, for eternity, will be physical beings, not just spiritual beings, spiritual and physical together, as we are now, but no longer under the curse. These same bodies, in the confessions they say, this self-same body, you know, that will be raised. We will live as resurrected people on a resurrected earth. Part of our problem envisioning resurrection, you know, resurrection is one of those doctrines that there are people who will die for, but they don't actually believe it. And I think part of our problem is when we talk about a physical resurrection, if we don't think about a larger context of a physical new earth, which Scripture clearly teaches, but we sometimes or often seem to miss, then we think of this physical body, but how physical can it be? Because it's drifting around where the angels live? Or no, it's on a new earth. In other words, the physical resurrection of the individual cannot make complete sense until you picture the physical resurrection of the earth itself, as the new body is the old body made new in resurrection. So the new earth is the old earth made new in resurrection. And that is where we will live forever. And God's original plan that man and woman would have dominion over the earth, would rule the earth to the glory of God. Read that in Genesis 1 and 2. It's just everywhere there. Ruling over the animals and over all creation and developing it to the glory of God. We act as if Satan came in there and ruined God's plan, and his desire for righteous human beings to rule the earth to his glory was somehow permanently set aside. In actual fact, Jesus Christ came into the world not simply to save our souls, but to redeem the whole person, the whole body, and the whole physical earth. The universe in which we live, the new heavens and the new earth, are resurrected heavens and resurrected earth, so that indeed, forever, on planet earth, God's righteous people will rule that earth to his glory.